Members of Parliament have come out to protest the unfair allocation of district development expenditure funds in the 2022-2023 financial year budget, accusing ministers of allocating more funds to their home districts. Dan Kimisho, the Kazo County MP, and David Kabanda of Kasambia County blew the whistle via their social media accounts this week.
Unfairness in the distribution of the national cake, the sharing of the national cake. When you look at the appropriation bill before us now, there are districts that have been allocated over 10 billion, 10, 11, 12. Where other districts are allocated 2, 1 billion, 3 billion, 3-fold, same districts, same population.
You have seen how Ministry of Finance ministers, Prime Minister, ministers under the office of the Prime Minister and other ministries have benefited in this budget. How can you allocate yourself 12 billion with a population of 90,000 people and leave a district with a population of 500,000 people with only 6 billion?
Districts such as Kayunga, Adjumani, Kibale, Kakumiro, Rubanda, Isinjiro, among others which are home to powerful ministers in cabinet, are in the spotlight as MPs wonder why they were allocated huge amounts of capital development funds regardless of other factors. They have vowed to overturn the proposed unfair allocations while considering the 2022-2023 financial year budget.
It is hurting that we have not had equitable distribution of resources in this country. We have diverted from planning because of need. We plan because of connection. And you can see where it is leading us.
These ministers, some of them are greedy. Let me tell you, the first attention should be given to these new districts that were created. Let me tell you, if you go to district Kalungu, Bukomansimbi, many of them, Karenga in Karamoja, those districts don't even have a single road over tarmac. They don't have road units. When you look at the schools we have, they don't have health centers, 4. You find a new district with health centers, 3, as there are many. Hospital.
Lawmakers accuse their colleagues in cabinet of misusing their positions to influence inequitable budgetary allocations at a disadvantage of districts that are badly off. They questioned why new districts are not given priority yet they lack a lot of equipment and resources to get fully operational.
Here they've been insisting that allocations to local government should have a demographic formula. And then you also bring in an element territory.
I think as we are revising and going through this appropriation bill, among others, these are areas we need to ponder and consider. Otherwise, the country is moving wrong. We are moving on the wrong direction. We must appropriate in areas with higher population than appropriating in areas just because a minister comes from there.
The Shadow Minister for Finance, Mwanga Chivumbi, has called on the Inspector General of Government to take interest in the case and dig out fresh interest in cabinet appropriations.
The IGIG should ideally interest himself in this matter. It's against ethical and moral conduct of leadership. How do you dare allocate huge sums of money to where you come from when you were minister?
I really feel the IGG should interest itself into this matter, because if the district where the minister is coming from is more favored than the district without the minister, there it puts Uganda at a total risk and in a very awkward manner. So the IGG should interest itself, investigation be done.
However, the Minister of State for Finance, Henry Musasizi, has explained the criteria which was used in allocation of development expenditure funds to districts, saying the matter of planned activities is key. He dismissed the allegations of self-aggrandizement in members of cabinet.
First of all, our budget starts from zero base, and they are largely activity-based. It is not district X with such amount of money. what activity is being done in this district. We also look at the numbers. We have districts with one constituency.
Report by Fred Kajubi for the news.